Fasting, hallelujah, good news, right?
Yeah.
We will be fasting, thank you, Jesus, hallelujah. Our fasting, we'll be doing a 10-day fast, 10 days fasting and prayer from December, for the month of December, Monday, December 19th to Friday, December 23rd. And then we'll pick up Monday, December 26th to Friday, December 30th. We'll be praying using the same prayer points used in November and have corporate prayers by the teleconference line, which is the EMS line, at 9 p.m. on each night of the fast. So please, don't forget, set the alarm. Whatever it is that you need to do, please remind yourself to be connected in Jesus' name. Amen. Beloved, in this season, do not let your hearts be troubled, stressed, agitated. You believe in and are here to and trust in and rely on God. Believe in and are here to and trust in and rely on me. This is from the Amplified, and it's John 14, verse 1. God is telling us, as we trust in God, we should also trust in Him and rely and depend on Him. In Jesus' name. Amen and amen. I have no testimony tonight, but we are so grateful that we are alive and we are breathing tonight in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Okay, so we'll be moving over into our declaration tonight. Hallelujah. Amen. 2022
is our year of
advancing the frontiers of the kingdom.
Advancing the frontiers of the kingdom.
We declare that. We are growing in the grace and knowledge of the Lord Jesus. We are getting more intimate with the Holy Spirit. We are getting more sensitive to the Holy Spirit. We are abounding more and more in the love of God. We are boldly preaching Christ every day to the world. We are serving God better. We are expanding more and more on all sides and in every way. We are advancing the frontiers of God's kingdom. Hallelujah! Thank you, Jesus. Why you guys sound so quiet? Are you cold? Hallelujah. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen. At this time, we'll be calling on Minister Lukman Latina, who will be taking our offering and the word for us tonight. Hallelujah. Make him welcome as he comes up.
Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord. I don't know about you, but I am very excited to be here tonight. I am very, very excited. Are you excited to be in the house of the Lord? Are you excited to be in the house of the Lord? David said, I was glad when he said, let's go to the house of the Lord. Why? Because he knows that he is going to be blessed. He knows that he's going to be blessed. He knows that he's going to be blessed. So it's time for offering. It's time for our offerings.
Thank you, Jesus.
And it's time for our tithes. So let's open our scripture tonight to 1 Timothy chapter 6. 1 Timothy chapter 6. And I'll be reading from verses 17 to 19. 1 Timothy chapter 6. And I read, check them that are rich in this world, that they be not high-minded, nor trust in uncertain riches, but in the living God who giveth us richly all things and joy. That they do good, that they be rich in good works, ready to distribute. Are you ready to distribute tonight? That's what the Lord is asking you. Are you ready to distribute out of his is of no relevance anymore as far as wealth is concerned in Nigeria. But if he has done something that has blessed the people and continue to bless the people, that name will still be well spoken of. We hear about the Rockefeller Foundations. Rockefeller has died how many years? Many, many years ago. We hear about so many foundations. We hear about, you know, how people have used their wealth to bless people. And what he has done has immortalized their name forever. So, brethren, we need to think very well that whatever the Lord has, and you don't need to be a millionaire before you start to bless people. You don't even need to be a Tanzania. No. You can start to bless people with your nickels and dimes, with your hundreds, with your tens, and also advance the kingdom of God with it. And surely, but the word of God says that the Lord will open the windows of heaven and he will pour out his blessings upon you that your bag will not be able to contain. That is a promise. And you know that whatever God has said, so long as you keep the bag, your own bagging, God never fails. He will definitely keep his own bagging. Bear all this in mind. So as we begin to write our checks, as we begin to get ourselves together to bless the Lord tonight, let's keep all these things in mind. That your money, when you give it, it's going to be very good use for the advancement of the kingdom through Christ Temple. Can we have the ways of...
Hello, Christ Temple. It's offering time, and these are the ways to give. Give by Cash App, enter $CTDarby, or text CTCell at 215-730-6752. Or text to give, text the amount you want to give to 814-292-1823 and follow the simple instructions. To give online, go to our website www.ctwoc.org and click on the red give sign. To give on PayPal, enter ct@ctwoc.org. For mail and offering, mail to Christ Temple, 27 South 5th Street, Darby, PA, 19023. To access all these ways to give, scan the QR code on the screen right now, and may God bless you as you do so.
Lord, O God, in obedience, O God, to your words, your children have given generously, without compulsion. Father God, I pray, O God, that you will bless all our givings tonight. In the name of Jesus. Lord, I pray, O God, because I know that no one can outgive you. Lord, as your children has given faithfully tonight, Lord, according to your word, you said you will cause the heavens to be open over them, and you will add your blessings. Lord, let it be so, as for as many as has given tonight, Lord, let there be an outpouring of your blessings towards them. Father, we thank you, and we bless your holy name tonight. We give you all the glory, all the honor and adoration. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed with thanksgiving. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you so much, choir. You have really, really led us tonight into the presence of God Almighty. The worship was very, very powerful. Very, very powerful.
Yes.
Well, brethren, I just want to say I am glad to be in the house of the Lord tonight. I am very glad. I don't know about you.
Yes.
I don't know about you, but I know that I am blessed. I know I am excited to be in the house of the Lord tonight. I know that I am very, very happy to be in the presence of God. I know that I am very, very happy to be alive today. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of. I'm sure some of you have not seen me as excited as you before. Oh, I am excited to be here tonight. I am excited to be here tonight. And I give you two reasons why I'm excited. I am excited because I am alive. I am alive. And that is pregnant with so much meaning. You guys don't know what the Lord did for me and my family. Oh, Siriaba, Yinkasandama, Yerebo Sintama Kayama. That I am alive today. Father, I know it's because of your goodness. You don't know. Let me just be a simple glimpse. Oh, I'm not wasting your time tonight. On Sunday night, I was going to walk with my wife. We walk in the same place. I do part-time. Maybe where she walks. And we're driving. We were just talking. We're going down Merriway. That was around 11 o'clock p.m. And suddenly the routes, the route that we are so used to, I go through there during the day, at night, every time. We go through that place. Rich Pike. It's a family, you know, if you come from Norristown, to come to Philadelphia, you're either going to go through Germantown Pike or you're going to go through Rich Pike. And usually I like to go through Rich Pike. It's much faster. And suddenly we got to this area and the whole place was blackened. And I didn't take too much notice of it. I was probably going between 40, 50 miles an hour. And suddenly, I saw right in front of me across the road, a light pole has fallen. It happened so suddenly, and I could not, there was no way for me to maneuver. This was an electric pole lying across the street. You know how tall the electric, there was no way I could maneuver. And the only thing I could do was just go eat it and go. And we had to observe that the car was going to somersault at the way we were going. But God was going to take care of what thank God God took care of. The car did not flip over. We landed in the median, and then we were so shaken, we didn't know what even happened. Suddenly we saw there were some cars coming, and they were almost running into that same, but because they saw us, so everybody started, you know, stopping. And then we called 911, and then the police came, the fire came, ambulance came, and they quickly go down of the place, you know. And I was wondering, how did I see that, you know? But I didn't really know what really happened, you know. And so, but the good thing was that none of us was injured. Not even a scratch, you know. And so as I started processing the whole thing, to cut the long story short, we discovered that just before we got to that junction, another car has hit the pole. And that's why the pole fell across. And when it fell, the whole light was taken in that area. The area that usually well lit turned into darkness. And that was why we did not see that electric pole with light wire lying across. You know? So, you know, that's what really happened. But we thank God.
Yes.
I mean, the car was a total loss, which is a thing. I don't even worry about that. But I am so happy that we are alive today.
Yes.
We are alive today to give glory and honor and adoration. You know, and there is something. Even for those of you who are listening to me on this line, you know, if you are listening virtually, be grateful that you are associated with Christ Temple. I'm not saying this with, you know, with just anyhow. Be grateful that you are associated with a praying church. Not only a praying church, but a church that teaches the word. And be happy that you are under the coverage of a man of God who is genuine.
Yeah.
Honestly. Because I know from us, I've been associated with Christ's temple for a long time. And I know how God has snatched people out of the mouth of the lion in this ministry.
Yeah.
How many do we want to count? Things that are taking people away. God has done it. Did it. In this place, kept people alive. And I am a living testimony that the enemy failed again.
Yeah.
They failed again. It was a black bullet, as Pastor would say. A black bullet, they fired. But it was a black bullet. It's a black bullet. It's a black bullet. So when the man of God says, let's pray, don't grumble. When he says, let's fast, don't grumble. Because he's been led by the Spirit. By the Spirit of God. Oh, so we just want to thank you. We just want to thank you. The other thing why, you know, because, you know, I mean, since I know I'm going to be doing Bible study, I'll go from one topic to another. Because I just don't want to come and just say something. I want people to be blessed. I want the right message. You know. And I never really got anything. But as I was sitting down yesterday, you know, the Lord just brought my attention to talking, dwelling in the secret place.
Hallelujah.
Dwelling in the secret place. And of course, the
the passages, you know, that, you know, was the Psalm 91 and Psalm 27. And as Pastor started the minister this morning, which passage did he minister with? Psalm 91. And I said, oh, he's going to give all my messages today. All the EMS. But you know what I said? There is no plagiarism in the kingdom of God. And I said, you know what? That is a confirmation of what the Lord wants us to focus on tonight.
Yeah.
So, if I begin to give you prayer points like God, Pastor gave, please know that this is what the Lord wanted us, you know, to share this night. And it is not going to be a typical, it's not going to be a typical Bible study. You know, we are going to be led by the Spirit of God. But let's quickly open to those two scriptures, Psalm 91. And I also read Psalm 27, verses 5 to 6. I'll start with Psalm 27, verses. I'll read from 4 to 6. It says, one thing have I desired of the Lord, that will I seek after, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life. All the days of my life. That is the desire of the psalmist. And that should be the desire of every child of God. That you will dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of your life. To behold the beauty of the Lord and to inquire in his temple. Why? For in the time of trouble, he shall hide me in his pavilion. In the secret of his tabernacle shall he hide me. He shall set my feet upon a rock. Now, verse says, and now shall my head be lifted above my enemies, run about me. Therefore will I offer in his tabernacle sacrifices of joy. I will sing, yay! I will sing praises unto the Lord. Brethren, you need to call upon the Lord this night. Let every other desire disappear. Let the desire to dwell, the desire to dwell in the house of God, let it rest upon you tonight. Let it rest upon you. You see, some people, the only thing they desire is money. Ah, God, I must be rich. Yes, it's good to be rich. But that richness, that money is temporary. It's temporary. It is not eternal. Whatever you see, whatever your eyes see, they are temporary. But what you don't see, they are the eternal things. You need to hunger and thirst for eternal things of the word of the Lord. Thirst for your presence with the Lord. Thirst as Lord. Put that desire in me. Desire to fellowship. The desire to fellowship with the Lord. Through his word, through prayer, through communion. Lord, put it over. Let it be an overriding desire. Let it be an overriding desire in my life, oh God. In the name of Jesus. Because what? There is a blessing of it. Because when it says, in the time of trouble, he will hide you in his Babylon. He will hide you in his Babylon. As the Lord Father, as the enemy comes, as they come like a flood, yet let your spirit raise a standard against them. As they come now against me, against my children, against my loved ones, like a flood, let your spirit raise a standard. Let your spirit raise a standard in the name of Jesus against them, O God. Hide me in your pavilion. Hide me in your pavilion. Overshadow me. Cover me with your shadow. 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 Cover my children. Cover my loved ones. Cover my wife. Cover my husband. By your shadow, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. I pray, oh God, in your secret place. Lord, I pray. Lord, I pray. Lord, I pray. Set my feet upon a rock. Oh, Masiriaba. Set my feet upon a rock. Oh, set my feet upon a rock. That rock is Jesus Christ. Set my feet upon a rock. Set my feet upon a rock. Set my feet upon the word of God. Masiria. Jesus is the rock. Jesus is the one. Set my feet upon the word of God. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. When your feet is set upon the rock, you cannot be moved. You cannot be moved. Yes, wind will come. Makasin, hurricane will come. Yes, Kasina, wave will come. But you will be found standing. You will be found standing. You will be found standing. Masayama. Orebo Sinda Makayama. Yini Kasanda Makayama Sendeya. Lord, we bless your holy name tonight. Lord, your name will go. Ah, you to ask, Father. Now, oh God. Oh, let my head be lifted above my enemies round about me. Let my head, let my head be lifted. Let my head be lifted above every enemy round about me. Let my enemy, my senior, let my head, let my head, let my head, let my head be lifted above every enemy. Back I said never. Yirikasana, whether they are principalities, whether they are powers, whether they are spiritual wickedness, whether they are dark powers, let my head, let my head, let my head be lifted, be lifted, be lifted above those of my enemies. Round about me, 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 round about me. Lift up my head, oh God, lift up my head above those of my enemies. Round about me. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you. Father, we bless your name. Let's open to Psalm 91. Psalm 91. Marcus Dariana. Holy Bayare Bosin Dariana. And I read, he that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of Almighty. You see again, shadow. 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 Of God Almighty. When the shadow of God Almighty is upon you, that means that the whole entire glory of God is covering you. It's covering you. And when the glory of God covers you, that means that the power of God is enveloping you. That means that the blessing of God is upon you. That means that the protection of God is upon you. That means that, oh, Syria, oh, my Savior, oh, grace is upon you. Grace is upon you. That is what the shadow of God Almighty will bring into the life of any believer. Mercy, ask the Lord to cover you, cover your home, cover your children, cover your business with His glory, with His glory, with His glory. Lord, cover me. Lord, cover my children. Lord, cover my spouse. Lord, cover my business. Cover, cover my life. Cover my ministry with your glory, Lord. 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 In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. I will say of the Lord, verse 2, He is my refuge and my fortress. My God, in Him will I trust. The word of God says, some trusted in chariots. Some trusted in their physical power. Some trusted in their financial authority and power. Some trusted in their political connection. The word of God says, all these things will fail. Yeah, Masiria, Makasodoria, but those who put their trust in the Lord, yeah, Makasodoria, shall not be disgraced. Shall not be disgraced. Shall not be disgraced. Yet, Kasinda Makaribo said, he said, oh, he is my refuge and my trust. My God, in him will I trust. Because if you put your trust in the Lord, you shall never be disappointed. If you put your trust in the Lord, you shall never be disgraced. Oh, Masinda. Yet, Makaribo said, he said, surely, surely, certainly, surely, certainly, he will honor. He is shall deliver thee from the snare of the fowler. Pastor, explain what a fowler is. A fowler is an hunter. And what does the hunter do? They hunter for prey. And they set snare. Trap. See how powerful the lion is. When the hunter decides to set a trap for the lion, depending on the nature of the trap, if the lion there enters it, he is stuck there. He is stuck there with all his strength. He will not be able to come out except somebody shows him mercy and open the gates. Mercy, no matter how strong you are, if you enter, oh God, into the snare of the fowler, depending on the nature of that snare, and the enemy know how to make snare. Rebosida, that will keep the children of God. Mercida, except the Lord show them mercy, they will keep them there for years. Oh God, Mercida, I will call them to have limitation. Limitation in terms of their expressions. Mercida, all of us in that Macarena, as the Lord, oh God, tonight, oh God, every trap that has been set in waiting for you, Mercida Kadeva, let that trap remain empty. According to the pastor, according to the prayer of the pastor's mind, let every trapping, let every snare remain empty. That is when it's empty, you are not caught in that snare. You are not caught in that snare. Rama Sandaria, all of us in that. Every snare that the enemy has put lying away for you, let them remain empty. Let them remain empty by the mighty hand of God. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, as many as have been caught in the trap, but still ever, of the enemy, of the other, today by the finger of the only one of Israel, we begin to break open those snares. We break them open. We break them open by the mighty hand of God Almighty. The Lord that led Peter out of the snare of Aaron is leading somebody out tonight. He's leading somebody out tonight. Yay, hey, that same God. That same God has not changed. He has not changed. Mercy never. That same God is leading somebody out of the snare of the enemy tonight. Oh God, every snare, oh God, no matter the material is broken. Tonight is broken. We escape. Every snare, we escape. Every prison, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. He said that verse 5 says, thou shalt not be afraid of the terror by night, nor the arrow that fly by day. That means that at night there are forces called terrors that operate. They operate, Makasedoria. And even during the day, there are arrows that are flying. Arrows of infirmities that are flying. Arrows, oh God, Father. Yekasida. Arrows, satanic arrows, demonic arrows, masin deniaba, all of us in the Macarena, arrows that want to send backwardness, Macassene, into the life of God's people, masin deniaba, all of us in the Macarena, send deniaba, yeah, Macassene, because you are abiding, oh God, in the secret place, or the most high, you will not be afraid, yeah, Cassida, of the terror of the night. You will not be afraid of the arrows that fly by day. Why? Like I said earlier, not the pestilence that walketh in darkness, nor for the destruction that wasted and you know. Look at what the psalmist was saying. He said there are some destructions. There are some forces called destruction. And their mission is to waste. To waste glorious destiny. To waste, oh God, businesses that are thriving. There are some forces, Rabosla, to destroy ministry. Yeah, Kasinda Makaibo Sendeleva. Hey, Rimo Sinda Makaibo Sendeleva. Oh, but the word of God says, 1,000 will fall at your side. 1,000 will fall at your side, 10,000 at your hand, but it shall not come near you. Those destructions will never come near you. In the name of Jesus, those destructions, because your God is one that disappoints. Oh God, he disappoints the devices of the craft. He disappoints the devices of the craft. I decree and I declare over everyone here tonight. Let every device of the enemy be disappointed as we speak. Let every device of the enemy, against you, Masina, be disappointed in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Let every altar speaking against you, every altar speaking against your home, every altar speaking to your marital destiny, every altar speaking against your financial destiny, Rebosina, let those altars begin to collapse. In the name of Jesus, I speak to altars in this atmosphere. I speak to satanic altars, demonic altars, altars of witchcraft, yes, Cassidaria, all that have been established in families, oh God, that have been affected destinies for years, for generations. Today, let those altars begin to collapse. Let those altars begin to collapse. Let those altars begin to collapse. In the name of Jesus, let those altars catch fire. Let them catch fire. Let them catch fire. Of the Holy Ghost, Rebosina. Altars begin to break. Altars begin to break. Altars begin to break. Altars, satanic altars, break. In the name of Jesus, break, 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 break. Chains, let chains begin to fall. Let chains begin to fall. Let chains begin to fall. Let chains begin to fall from the hands, from the feet of God's people. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Rima Sandari. Marika Sinda Mayere was Sinda Makaria. Hey! Pastor, say no evil shall befall you. Maybe people don't have understanding this place tonight. The word of God says, No evil shall befall you. No evil shall come into your home. No evil shall come into your living room. No evil shall come into your bedroom. No evil shall come into your kitchen. No evil shall come into your toilet. As you go out, my sister, no evil will befall you. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. We cancel all manners of death. We cancel all manner of death. We cancel all manner of death in your home, in your home, in your family, among your loved ones. We cancel, we nullify every manner of death. Premature death, back as soon as ever. Yes, the devil. Premature death, we cancel you. 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 Because we have been bought by the precious blood of Jesus. Masinia. Yes, the devil. The blood of Jesus is speaking. He's speaking for us and against death. He's speaking against death. He's speaking against calamity. He's speaking against destruction. In the name of Jesus. 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 Finally, ask the Lord, empower me. Empower me tonight. Power that cannot be disgraced. Power that cannot be easily disgraced. Power that will make it to tread upon lion and adder. Yeah, back to the devil. Power. 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 Wonder working power. Wonder working power. Power that cannot be disgraced. Power that cannot be disgraced. Power that cannot be confronted. Masinaba. Yeah, by satanic powers. Holy Masana. Lord, clothe me with your power tonight. Clothe me, oh God, with your power. With your power. With your power. With your power. Holy Masinaba. Yeah, Masana. Release your anointing. Release your anointing upon me tonight. In the name of Jesus. 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 Oh, Father, we just want to bless your holy name tonight. Father, we give you glory. We give you glory. We give you glory. We give you honor and adoration. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying with thanksgiving.
Amen.
Amen. Let's be seated. In the little time that we have, I'm just going to give you, you know, the advantages, the benefit of living in the sacred place of the Most High. I will list 10, then we'll start to talk about it. So wherever we end, at least you have the benefit of knowing why you need to abide in the sacred place. Why you need to dwell in the sacred place. And when we talk about dwelling, we are not talking about somebody who comes constantly into the sacred place and go. No. We are talking about somebody who has made the secret place of the Most High his place of abode. His place of abode.
That's right.
And when we are talking about the secret place of the Most High, we are not talking about a physical place. No. Some might think, oh, maybe you have kept a place for yourself in your house where you go to pray. You think that's a secret place? No, that's not. You are just kept a place where you mingle with God, which is good. But when we are talking about the secret place, we are talking about your relationship with Jesus. We are talking about your relationship with Jehovah. This is a place where your soul is in solitude, one-on-one with God. And the starting point is this. Before you can dwell in the secret place, you must have given your life to Jesus. That means that you are a born-again child of God. And then that means you become part of the body of Jesus Christ. And the word of God says that as a part of the body of Jesus Christ, He says you are made to sit in the heavenly places in Christ, far, far above the riches of principalities and powers and spiritual wickedness in high places. I hope somebody gets this tonight. I hope as a child of God, you do not have to fear about demonic powers. You do not have to fear about principalities and powers. Because why? Because you reside. You reside far, far above their riches. You are seated in Christ Jesus. You are seated in Christ Jesus in the heavenly places. Far, far above principalities. Far, far above powers. Far, far above dark powers. Don't get me wrong. That we don't have they have demonic powers. Yes. There are principalities. There are territorial spirits. Terrible, terrible demonic powers. Yes. But thank God for the grace. Thank God for the grace that we have in Christ Jesus. That is why we are able to confront them. That is why we are able to trample upon them. It says you will trample upon the lion and the adder. He's not talking about physical lion. No, he's talking about powers. That you will trample upon them. Not because of your own self, but because you are part of the body of Christ. And Christ is the head of that body. And if as a child of God, you make available you avail yourself of all the things that Christ has provided in terms of prayer, in terms of fasting, in terms of walking in faith, in terms of evangelism, in terms of studying the word. Then that means that you are developing strength. You begin to develop strength, and therefore that makes it very easy for you to comfort principalities and powers. And God begin to teach you and lead you what you need to do, even if you are confronted. God begins to show you. God begins to direct you. If it's something that you need to confront, directly, He will tell you. If it's something that you say, keep quiet. Just listen. let me deal with this. You'll be directed. But the thing is this, they will not have power over you. No matter how thick, no matter how thick darkness is, let them bring the thickest darkness and the appearance of light. Hey, that darkness will begin to dissipate. It will begin to dissipate. And the more, the stronger the light, that darkness will completely disappear. There is no way darkness cannot overcome light. You are children of God. You are children of light. Therefore, you have authority over dark powers. Over every form of darkness. You know, the problem is that we are very lazy. And that includes me. We don't want to fast. We don't want to pray. We don't want to do night vigil. And we want to walk in authority and power. It doesn't come that way. It doesn't come that way. You remember the seven sons of schemers. they saw Paul casting out demons. If this man can cast demons, we can cast demons too now. We can cast demons now. They didn't know the kind of authority that Paul was carrying. So they gathered themselves. The Bible says they gathered themselves, the seven of them. They took their strength in number. Physical strength. And the Bible showed that they didn't have understanding. They said, come out of him. That Jesus that Paul preached. The Jesus they don't know themselves. The Bible says that, you know, spirit talks. He said, Paul, I know Paul. He's my master. I can't even go near him. But who are you? Who are you? What's the idea? Before they could answer, that demon did the number on them. They were naked. Brethren, Christ therefore has made so many things available to build you up. We have Bible study. We have early morning showers. We have the Holy Ghost service. We have victory nights. Which one are you participating? You need to answer yourself. If you're on the line. Even if you didn't come, you can participate on the line. Some of us are not even participating on the line. That's dangerous. It is dangerous. It is dangerous, brethren. It is dangerous because the times are evil. The times are evil. Today, everything may be so rosy and everything. 1 minute. It has not changed. When we're going that Sunday night, they never knew we're going to encounter anything. And after that, we were so shaking. And on the light time, we'll go, don't do anything that will get you to police cruiser. Because it was so cold. And then the policeman said, okay, you know, you can come and take refuge in my cruiser. So he said, I'll put on the heat there. So he opened the door. And later, the thing just like, this is plastic. Very hard. You can't break it. And you cannot, once you are inside it and they lock the door, you can't come out. The policeman has to walk. We called for Uber and Uber was there and he couldn't get to us. So we are looking around to get out of this place. And the policeman was not around, so we were stuck inside that place. And so eventually, when he came, we said, he said, once you are inside this place,
you are inside.
It's only the policeman that can open it from outside. Ah!
And the Bible, he has a sense of humor. When he has us, he said, enjoy yourself. That's not enjoyment in this place. There is no enjoyment in police school. Well, let's continue. When we talk about dwelling in the secret place, we are talking about dwelling in the secret place of the Most High God. There is nothing higher or greater than our God. And it means that you are abiding under the shadow of God Almighty. What is the meaning of Almighty? That is, there is nothing impossible with Him. Almighty is Almighty. Over His has power over everything. And that in that realm, once in that realm, nothing shall be possible. I pray that you will get to that realm.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus. You begin to live in the realm of impossibility. So that when infirmity comes, you tell it to go. And it shall obey. When principalities and power come, it command them to bow. You cast them out. And they shall not resist you. Rabba Sinda Makaribo Sende Reba. Yeriba Sinda Makaribo Sende Reba. I in that realm, you can boldly say God is your refuge, is your fortress. Yeah, in Him you will put all your trust. The Bible says that some trusted in chariots, some trusted in horses. Say, but we will trust in the name of our God, because we know that chariot can fail. The horses can collapse. But as to put your trust in the Lord, you shall not be disgraced. In the name of Jesus. Now, when you live in the sacred place, you enjoy absolute God protection. You'll be like that day, like David. When he went to visit his brothers in the war front, and he saw the whole of the army of the children of God being disgraced by this uncircumcised Philistine. Because David knew who he was, he said, what will be done to whoever disgraces this uncircumcised Philistine? He said, oh, he's going to be mightily rewarded. He said, okay, I am going to face him. His brother said, look at this small boy now. You are too forward. They asked you to bring food. You just deliver the food and go. But he didn't pay them any mind, because he knew his God. He knew he was dwelling in the secret place. And look at what, and of course, we know what happened to at the end of the story. You know, even Goliath was felt disgraced. Who do you think this small tiny boy? Me? I've been a warrior all my life. So this is what you can say to me. Am I a dog that you, this boy is coming with? But David said with so much confidence that today is going to be your end. I will cut your head. And he did that. He was so bold. That is what the dwelling in the secret place will do to you. Listen to the three Hebrew children, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, when they asked them to bow to the God that the king Nebuchadnezzar. They said, oh Nebuchadnezzar, we are not careful to answer thee in this matter. See them speaking boldly. Young boys speaking boldly to the one that was ruling, even in the world at that time. Said, we are not careful. We are not even care who you are. We are not careful to answer thee in this matter. If it be so, our God, whom we serve, is able to deliver us from the burning fiery furnace. And he will deliver us out of thy hand, O king.
But if not, be it known unto thee, King, that we will see not serve thy God. They were so bold. They were so confident. Not worship the golden image without a second. Dwelling in the secret place of the Most High will give you so much boldness. So much boldness like Elijah that went to meet Ahab and said, see what how 1 Kings chapter 17 1 describes. Said, and Elijah the Tishbite, who was of the inhabitants of Gilead, said unto Ahab, as powerful as Ahab was, as the Lord God of Israel liveth, before whom I stand, there shall not be dew or rain this year, but according to my word. You think if you're not dwelling, if you don't know something, go and stand before the king and be making declaration. Not only do you make a declaration because the king has said, cut his head off right away. You are also sure that what you have said will come to pass. You said just made a declaration that there will be no deal. Do you know that every night you fall? Yeah. And rain falls at any season. Yeah. Elijah said, I have the authority to close the heaven. And he closed that heaven. Yes. The dew did not fall. Rain did not fall. He said, at my word. At my word. And I'm sure, Ahab with Jezebel's wife, they would have called all their prophets, the bad prophets, and sent them to start to prophesy or to make whatever. Nothing. That is what dwelling in the secret place. You are speaking the mind of God. You will be able to decry to brighter bones, like Ezekiel in chapter 7, that those bones that have been dead for many, many years, they should come to life, and they will come to life. Because you are speaking with authority and with power. You are in tune to the frequency of God. You are hearing what God wants you to hear. And you are listening to the instructions of God. Of God. And you are being directed. God is telling you what to say as his prophet. And you are saying it. You can boldly say to the Tabitha of your time, like Peter, and said, Tabitha, it is not time for you to die. Rise! Rise! And Tabitha will get up. You can say boldly, like Peter and John, to that layman at that beautiful gate, and say, silver and gold I don't have, but what I have that I'm very confident about is the word of God. In the name of Jesus, rise up and begin to walk. And the man will get up and begin to walk. Basiliaka. Hey, Rebosina. The Bible says this I've been written for our admonition. Yes. Peter, James, Paul, they are people of like passion like you and I. But what made the difference? What made the difference is their relationship with God. Is their relationship with God. They were ready to pay it all. Look at the summary of Paul. Oh, God bless you. Oh, blessed be the name of the Lord. I'm sure you see that portion where Paul summarizes his life. If I need to get there. Can somebody help me find it? Where Paul summarized towards the end of his life. Ramashina Makarama Sendiana. Oh, Emmanuel Cassandra, my year Cassandra. Oh, the machine that Rabo Sundu Koyaba. Oh, the machine that Yaba. Mm.
passion. That's not the passion. I'm talking about. He summarized towards the end of his life. You know, he says, you know, showing that he has paid all the prices and that he's waiting for it. But I can read up this portion and he says, you know, Second Timothy. Oh, blessed be the name of the Lord. Second Timothy. Yeah, okay. Oh, yeah, okay. Yes, look at the summary of Paul here. Said, for I am now ready to be offered, and the time of my departure is at hand. See, somebody says, I have fought a good fight. I have finished my course. I have kept the faith. Therefore, there is laid up for me a crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous Lord, shall give me at that day. And not only, mark it, not only me, but all of them also that have loved his appearing. Do you love the appearing of Jesus Christ? Are you preparing? The psalmist says, teach us how to number our days. Teach us how to number our days. Teach us how to number our days. In the secret place of the Most High, you will enjoy the powerful love of Christ. This is the love that motivated God to die for us. And that's why Paul can declare in Romans chapter 8 that verse 35 says, who can separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation or distress, or persecution or famine, or nakedness or peril or sword? But I says, as it is written, for thy sake we are killed all day long. We are accounted as sheep for the slaughter. See the experience of Paul. Nay, in all these things we are more than conquerors through him that loved us. Through him that loved us, we are more than conquerors. We are more than conquerors through him that loved us. You are more than conquerors if you consider the love of Christ. The love of Christ. What Christ did. He left, the Bible says, he left his glory. Verse 38 of that same chapter says, for I am persuaded that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor power, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any creature shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord. What Paul was saying is that take everything in totality. Nothing can separate him from the love of Christ. Nothing. You know some of us? I don't have a job. God, just give me this job. Give me this job, I will serve you. I will serve you. Just give me one. And God said, okay, my son. Not only give you one, gives you two. And suddenly we don't see in fellowship anymore. Brother, what happened? We don't see you in IBG. We don't see you in you are not tuned into early morning showers anymore. So is this job? Is this job? Oh my God. What is God says? Pastor says, shall we pray that God should take away this job that I can't say? See? Yes.
In this hidden place, we access the unlimited spiritual blessings. Let's go and see what Paul showed us. He said, blessed be the God and Father. I'm reading from Ephesians chapter 1, verse 5. He said, blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us with all spiritual blessings in heavenly places in Christ, according as he has chosen us in him before the foundation of the world, that we should be holy and without blame before him in love, having predestinated us unto the adoption of children by Christ, by Jesus Christ, to himself, according to the good pleasure of his will. As a child of God, you have been blessed, the Bible says, with all spiritual blessings, which includes forgiveness of sins, redemption, healing, deliverance, name it, that's even financial blessings. You know the problem that children of God have is that we lack knowledge and understanding. We lack knowledge of the principles of the kingdom. That's why the Bible says that my children perish for lack of knowledge. God will help us. In the secret place, we do not cohabit with demons, with principalities, with dark powers. You have left their domain. Bible says you are made to sit in the heavenly places in Christ Jesus. Far, far, far above the riches of principalities and powers and spiritual wickedness in high places. Because the power of God is unlimited, there is nothing that the power of God cannot do for us if we dwell in the secret place. That's what Paul prayed that prayer in Ephesians chapter 1 verse 16. It says that the eyes of our understanding be enlightened, that we may know what is the hope of his calling and what is the riches of the glory of his inheritance in the saints, and what is the exceeding greatness of his power towards us who believe, according to the working of his mighty power. Because when Jesus Christ comes to you, he does not leave anything behind. He comes into you with all his power and his glory. If you dwell in the secret place, you begin to enjoy the glorious inheritance and the potentials that are in Christ. In the secret place, you have the restoration power. Bible says that it says the power that raised Christ will transform you. That same power will wrought wonders. Amen. In your life. It says, in that same spirit that raised Christ from the dead dwells you, said, it will quicken your mortal body by that same spirit that dwells in you. Let's begin to round the Bible one more minute. When you dwell in the secret place, you become invisible to principalities and powers. What they see is just the glory of God in you and the working of his mighty power in you. If you continue to dwell in the secret place. Tonight, let's just pray the last hour. Lord, grace. Grace.
to dwell in your sacred place. Let it fall upon me tonight. And we are last prayer point.
Father, I've heard of the benefits of dwelling in your sacred place. Grace to dwell. Grace to dwell. Grace to dwell. Grace to dwell in your sacred place. Let it fall. Let it fall in this atmosphere upon your children. Grace to dwell. Grace to dwell. Grace to dwell without interruption. Grace to dwell without interruption. Grace to dwell, Father. Rabba Seda. Let it fall. Let it fall upon every man, every woman in this atmosphere. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Father, we just want to bless you tonight. Lord, we give you all the glory. We give you all the glory. We give you all the glory. We give you all the adoration. We thank you for all that you have done in our midst. Father, Lord, we return all glory unto you. Lord, let no man glory in your presence, O God. Father, Lord, as we leave, O God, from this place tonight, take us safely to our various homes. In the name of Jesus, we cancel every form of vehicular accident on the road. In the name of Jesus, every danger to happen, waiting to happen, Father, we cancel it. In the name of Jesus, we decree over homes in this place. No life will be lost in any home. In the name of Jesus, no home will suffer any loss, any type of loss. In the name of Jesus, Rema Sindiraba. Yerebo Sindaba, Karma Sindiraba. Hey, Rema Sindaba, Karma Sindiraba. Let your hand, O God, let the angels of your presence surround our homes, surround our vehicles. Go with us. Let your presence go with us everywhere we go, even from now, hold on to the end. In the name of Jesus, Father Lord, we thank you this tonight. Father Lord, we give you all the glory. Father Lord, we give you all the adoration. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying with thanksgiving. Amen.